Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Hey, are you ready to learn how to put wow factor into Glen Campbell song Southern Nights? Man, this is a great song. Great song for beginners, great song for seasoned players too. If you're a beginner, I'm going to show you how to play the chords that's going to make you sound cool. If you're a seasoned player, I'm going to show you how to put that wow factor riffs and fills to the chords to even make it sound even better. And hey, I don't know why I keep going on like this, because I know you want to learn it and I want to teach it. So get your pick, get your guitar, and meet me in the studio. And oh, by the way, warning, wow factor is contagious. See you in the studio. Okay, let me show you the chords that we're going to play, but before we get started, let me tell you that we're going to use the capo on the second fret, okay? So everything's in relation to the capo being on the second fret. Now, if you noticed when we played that song, and if you played along with me on the record, for whatever reason, that is tuned a little bit higher than 440, so I had to match the tone of the guitar up to the record to make it sound right. I've readjusted this and we're back to 440, so hopefully your guitar is in 440, and that's why it's a little bit different. But if you try and play along with the recording that I just did there, you'll need to play it by ear and raise that up just a little bit from the 440. It's up just a little bit on that. Okay, so anyway, here's the chords for this, and you got a D chord. And I'll put the chord diagrams up there for you. You're also going to have a D7. We don't do that D7 too much. I usually use that D in there, but that D7 is a nice little chord, and we may throw it in. We've got an E7. Okay, now the way I want you to play that E7 on this one, though, I'm going to play an E, and I'm going to take my pinky, and I'm going to put it on the third fret of that second string. Now, you can play an E chord, a regular E, and put that up there, and that's going to make it an E7, or you can take this ring finger off and put that, if you can't use your middle finger on that, go ahead and just take your, play a regular E7 like that. But for if you're a beginner, you'll want to play your E7 regular. But if you can put that wow factor in, you're going to want that pinky on that third fret of that second string. You can either play a regular E like I said, or you can take that ring finger off and play it. I do it both ways. Usually, because I'm doing wow factor, I'm going to play with that E chord because I want to get, I want to throw a couple of little licks in there. Okay, so you got the E7. You've got a G. Regular G chord. Okay, now, so it's. Now, if you're gonna play it with a D chord, you wanna do it like play that D, and I'm still playing those riffs in there, but my strumming, if you look at my strumming hand, I'm hitting the fourth and the third strings down there just to give it a little bit more. Actually, I'm hitting 5, 4, and 3. You can do it like that just to get a little bit more sound in there. But or you can just play the regular notes. Then what he does this neat little riff there to get into the chords, and it goes like this.